Hello, everybody. Welcome to CE 101 Introduction to Civil Engineering and Career Planning lecture of today. We will have exciting and interesting presentations today from all your classmates. In this project, Project 2, you were given the opportunity to design and construct the town of your dreams. As a joint venture founded by two companies, you were supposed to develop an area in Istanbul or Kocaeli, which will be holding about 100,000 people. You have the opportunity to use most modern construction technology and materials, and you will design, you will construct, and then actually, you will decide what to have in this town in terms of residential, commercial buildings, sport complex, movie houses, transportation facilities, whatever you choose. And in this project, actually, you worked six people all together and you handled all the parts of the projects together. And you showed your progress every week. And you came to the point to present your results. And we are here, actually, I'm sure you are all excited. And we are here to listen to all these presentations. Let's proceed.
Şu an gözüküyor mu hocam?
Yes, I can see. Let's start.
Hello everybody. As companies Beton and Team MSI, we will talk about the town of our dreams in Muallimköy. Let's take a look at the topics we will talk about first in our presentation. I will explain part introduction. Mrs. İrem will explain the parts location and financial planning. Mr. Mert will explain the part design. Mr. Sevban will explain the part construction states. Mr. Furkan will explain the parts geographical structure and quality management. Finally, Mr. Halil will explain the parts safety concern and environment. In this section, I will give information about the town. The regions we choose in the project are bordered by a red line. It stands out with its social and cultural living spaces. Trade is also an important part of the town. At least 100,000 people will live in our town. Can you continue from here, Mrs. İrem? Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is İrem. We choosing the colored areas we decided by considering various station. The colored areas are as follow: one is zoo, two is airport, 3 is seaport, 4 is water treatment plant, 5 is residence living space, 6 is sport facility, 7 is shopping center and fun fair, 8 cemetery, 9 hotel and business center, 10 schools, 11 university, 12 students dormitories, 13 hospital, and stadium, 15 town hall, 16 another hospital, 17 siteler, 18 industrial area, and 19 bus station. Financial planning, our cost target for the project before starting the project was 24, 25 billion Turk liras. Our project cost experimentally to 28 billion Turk liras, and we completed the project approximately 7 billion Turk liras below our target. Thank you. Mert, it's your turn.
Hi, everyone. My name is Mert. I will talk about design and construction planning. First, we identified the areas where we would place the structure, and then we did the infrastructure work. We determined the means of transportation and the general materials to be used in the structures. We have created all the structure within the framework of aesthetic, economic, and ergonomic values. Next page, please. We have built our city structures and areas, hospital, airports, university, service building, site, zoo, bus station, hotels, and business center. For the education, we have built our buildings and fields. General materials we used in structures, gypsum, aerated concrete. Aerated concrete is a structure that is very light and concrete, like compared to normal concrete. And aluminium, cement, and iron. Thank you.
Hi, I am Sevban. I am talk about construction stages. First of all, an excavation machine was chosen with map engineer the land where the building will build. Excavation were made with suitable construction equipment. Then stone gyps was sprinkled and excavated area was gravel level drainage. Pipes were laid according to the slope. Suitable gravetone was poured on the stone gyps. Isolation has been done. Raft foundation irons were laid. Foundation concrete was poured according to static plan. Base molds were made. Irons were laid and concrete was poured on it. Stone gyps were sprinkled on it. Then mesh irons were laid and lean concrete was poured. Column molds made and concrete poured, deck concrete poured. Finally, the walls were made and lintels and ceiling filling materials were prepared. Thanks.
Şu an görüntü gözüküyor mu?
Yes.
Hi, my name is Furkan. I tell you geographical structure and climate and soil properties and quality management. Geographical structure and climate, the region that we select is located in İzmit Gulf of Marmara region and one of the fastest growing Turkish districts is located in Gebze. We establish a new district with a surface area of approximately 25 kilometers square from Gebze district center to the beginning of the Osman Gazi Bridge. It is under the influence of the Black Sea and Mediterranean climates. The summer months are hot and less rainy in the district. The winter months are rainy and warm. Soil properties. The area covered by the district, rocky and filling, has been formed. The most widely distributed soil type in the district that we will establish and Gebze are brown forest soil that does not contain limestone. The most widely distributed soil type in the district we will establish and Gebze is forest soil that does not contain brown limestone. Quality management. The purpose of our quality management as Beton and Team MSI to fulfill the obligation of quality legislation by using the height quality components we can use in our buildings. Building solid and durable buildings to protect the safety and health of our customers, and buildings that appeal to the ACE that make their life easier to ensure their satisfaction. Carrying out activities aimed at eliminating and reducing all risk. Thank you.
Thank you, Furkan. Sesin geliyor mu?
Yes, we can see. We can hear. We can see your screen. No problem.
I will talk about two topics today. The first one of the environmental issues, water pollution. Sometimes we may be faced with water pollution. We established treatment facilities in our city in order to eliminate this problem. Second one, transportation problem. Industry and population are increasing in growing and developing cities. Accordingly, there is a transportation problem. In order to prevent this, we try to keep the road network in our city at the maximum level. In addition, we built a subway to ease transportation to our city. Third one. The first thing to solve this problem is to increase the number of public transportation networks. In this way, we aimed to reduce the use of private vehicles and thus minimize the amount of exhaust gas. Secondly, the factor that negatively affects the air quality is the gases from the chimneys of the factories in the industrial zones. Here, we installed filters in the factory chimneys. Soil pollution. Soil pollution, we established a solid waste facility in our city. Thus, we separated harmful substance and collected our wastes in one point. Safety concerns. In order for a building to be safe, it must be designed correctly. The material must be chosen correctly and according to design, the construction must be carried out in accordant with the design. It must be adequately inspected at every stage and necessary care must be taken during the use piece. The right material. In the design of the structure, the most suitable materials for the carrier system material must be selected. We took care to use the suited materials in our buildings. Correct construction. It is essential that the design is exactly followed during the construction phase and not to go outside the project. As a group, we have ensured that the buildings are inspected from the beginning and to the end. Correct use. It should be used according to functions considered while designing the buildings. Since we built a city from scratch, we didn't need to do anything under this heading in your buildings. Thank you for listening.
I have a question, teacher.
Go ahead, please.
Why did you choose this region?
Because when we look at the general region, we notice that this region is less developed than other regions. That's why we choose this region.
Any more questions? Well, maybe I can ask a question. What type of foundations did you use in your structures? Okay. Who is answering?
We use pile foundation and başka da gelmedi hocam.
Okay, I think you know you have a geotechnical team in your company also. Are you in geotechnical team?
Yes, outside? I am.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you probably have shallow foundations as well. Did you check the soil conditions at your site? Do you have high-rise buildings, Sevan?
Soruyor hocam, pardon. Evet, bilgisayar bir anda şey oldu. Pardon hocam. Tekrar sorunuzu alabilir miyim hocam?
Do you have high-rise buildings? And also please try to speak in English in the course. You know, this course is in English. And I am speaking okay. English and you should speak in English also.
Okay.
All right. My question is, do you have high-rise buildings here?
We built a high-rise plaza and hotel. We used C50 type ready mixed concrete. In its construction and hocam okay. Ben tam soruyu hani nasıl şey yapacağım anlamadım ya.
Okay, I think that's enough. Your answer is for now. Okay. Well, do you have any other questions for this company, joint venture? If not, we can continue with the second group, second company.
The second joint venture is Autumn and System. By the way, the previous presentation took around 11 or 12 minutes. So for the next joint ventures, you should present your presentation faster, I think.
So if we cannot finish it today, so we have to continue then next week, next Tuesday.
As you wish, Professor.
Can you see my screen?
Yes, now we can see.
Ömer.
Okay. Hi, today we will talk about our dream town. First of all, we choose Beşiktaş and its neighborhood because we didn't like what we see when we look at there. The main reason of this is unplanned urbanization. Now we will see construction stage in chronologic order.
Thank you, Ömer. Hello, everyone. Today I will talk about geotechnical part. As can be seen in this picture, the earthquake risk is quite high in our region. Therefore, we will use lead core rubber seismic isolator in all four our structures. In this picture, we see the lead core rubber seismic isolator. As seen in this picture below, we determine the general properties of the soil in that region after all tests performed. After this process, we found that the soil has the properties of Ransino type. We will use jet grout method for soil improvements. In this figure, we see the operation of the jet grout method. Good ground. The main reason why this ground is good is that it is far from the sea. Because of this, the risk of liquefaction is less. In addition, we have three residential areas and our town center in this region. Middle ground, for the reason I said in the previous section, the soil has average soil properties. And finally, bad ground. We named this part with the highest risk of liquefaction as bad ground. Also, single-story restaurants, stadium and picnic areas will be built in this region by taking necessary geotechnical measures. In this figure, we see the sample of liquefaction. And finally, in this part, we see the approximate budget that should be allocated for geotechnical operations. Thanks for your participation. My presentation is over. Now I leave the floor to Mehmet Kansuzar.
Thank you, Batuhan. Hello, everyone. I am Mehmet Kansuzar. Now I will tell you about hydraulic part. First of all, we determined the water source required for our town. Then we built a water exploration facility on an area of 20,000 square meters in the area where the dam cover is located. For the construction of the treatment plant, we were inspired by the Çanderesi water treatment plant. We used the pressure-resistant steel pipes to deliver the water treated in the treatment plant to the town. Later, we disrupted this water to reinforce the water tanks with steel pipes of different diameters. We built reinforced concrete water tanks of different volumes in the highest part of each residential area in the town. In addition, we used reinforced concrete tanks in the fire department, rainwater and treatment plant. HDPE pipes have been used to provide clean water to the town. We prefer these pipes because they are resistant to breaking and cracking. You can see the pipe line in the picture below. After examining the region in terms of elevation, a savage map was drawn. Concrete pipes of different diameters are used as pipe type. At various intervals, Kerman horns are positioned in shortened areas. For the rainwater collection line, the same pipe map was used as the wastewater line. The collected rainwater is saved in the water tank built near the coast and made ready for use. Unit price of some materials used in the field of hydraulics are given in the table below. Thank you, listen to me. I leave the floor to Ömer Yılmaz.
Hi, it's me again. As you can see in our design, we inspired from Barcelona. With this design, we plan to get rid of traffic jam, and also it looked like more organized. And this is part of our city. Also, we have asphalt that absorbs water. Also, there is 7.5 kilometer bicycle way, and we have a bulk path all along the seaside. We have a 5 kilometer metro line as top of the map. And there is marina and ferry line. You can dock your ship or boat to marina. And also, you can use ferry for go Anatolian side. Now I leave the floor.
Thank you, Ömer. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes. Hello, everyone. I am Mohamed Mahfuzuzen. I was interested in the structural part of this project. Our town consists of one city center, five neighborhoods, and coastal areas. In the town center, there will be more business buildings, municipality, cultural center, police headquarters, courthouse, district governorship, places of worship, shopping center, and residence. Neighborhoods will be used more as a living spaces. There will be sites redesigned in the neighborhoods. Apart from the estates, the neighborhoods will also have a family health center, veterinarian, police station, market areas, schools, and places of worship. There will be 9 buildings on the sites. The buildings have a total of 4 floors, and each building has its own car park. The ground floor of each building will be used as a shop, and apartment settlement will start from the first floor. There will be 30 schools in town. Each of these schools will have a sports hall and a basketball court in an open area. Thank you, listen to me. Ömer Beyaz will continue. Ömer, we can't hear you.
We can't hear you.
Sorry, Professor.
Go ahead, please.
Hello, everyone. I am Ömer. I will try to explain environment or our city. While designing our city, we gave importance to energy transformation and smart solutions. The environment of our city has been created within the scope of 3 important issues. First of all, minimizing carbon emissions. Carbon emissions refers to the release of carbon formaldehyde in nature into the atmosphere. Transportation vehicles in our city are vehicles with 0 emissions and do not harm the environment. Secondly, energy saving in the city. The using of solar panels in our city is quite high. In addition, the smart sensor street lights are available in the city. It only lowers the brightness levels. In this way, energy savings are achieved. We can see in this photo, these figures. Finally, environmental planning in city. There are green area, basketball courts, and recycling center in every city on our city. There are emergency collection area and green area in every neighborhood in our city. Recycling and energy saving are at the forefront in this library. We can see in this photo. Thank you for listening to me. I will leave here to Yusha Armak.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Yusha. I'm going to talk about material and safety part of this project. Firstly, I want to start about materials. We want to use best material everywhere because this is our dream project. You can see components in the table. We use environmentalist materials as possible. I think the most important of them solar panels and isolators because of they provide safe energy and resistance to natural disasters. Other topic is safety. We want to make safest place, so we decided to agreement with another company for this. Of course, we check every important point, but extra safety does not hurt. Thank you for listening.
Well,
I have a question.
Go ahead, please.
Which stage did you have the most difficulty while doing the project?
I can answer that. The financial part was very difficult. And also drawing part was very difficult because we didn't know how to use AutoCAD. First time, but we figured out, I think.
I have a question.
Go ahead, please.
Why did you use the jet grout as a soil improvement method?
I think I can answer that. We will use jet grout because this is both economical and up-to-date compared to other methods.
I guess. Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any more questions? Well, do you have high-rise buildings?
Yes, teacher. Yes, professor, sorry. In the our town center, we have a shopping mall and residence.
And you said you prefer to use seismic isolators. And do you have plans? You know, what buildings you are going to use this kind of systems?
Repeat again, please. I don't understand.
Okay, my question was, you said you are using or you are planning to use seismic isolators. Have you made any plans, you know, what buildings are you going to use this kind of isolators?
We use the seismic isolators only residential areas and important structures which are many people in live.
I can give example. For example, in residential building and hospital, I guess.
Yes.
Also in town stadium. Stadium is a very bad location, and we used isolator in stadium.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Let's proceed with the next group then.
The next joint venture is Temples and 3E.
Can you hear me?
Mm-hmm. Yes, we can hear you.
Hello everyone, I'm Emirhan. Today we are going to make a presentation about our city. Our city is formed by the combination of hundreds of buildings within an area of 25 square kilometers. The objectives of our project are to minimize damage to the environment, to use renewable energy resources, to use the possibilities as economically as possible by considering the coming centuries.
Hi everyone, I am Eren. After that, I will continue presentation. Our city is in an area of 25 square kilometers in Kadıköy. You can see the satellite image of the region we select and the topography map of the area in the pictures. In this photo, you see a representation of the structure in our city on the legend map. In these pictures, you can see the detailed AutoCAD drawing of our city.
In this slide, we see the cost of buildings in our town.
I'm Ayşenur and I will talk about design and construction planning. We have identified durability, livability, and sustainability as the three most important factors in all our buildings. The layout of some sites was not solid. After ground improvement, we applied rough foundation for the area of our sites and other structures. Also, we use seismic isolators. We choose green roofs and green facades for all buildings. Here you can see them. In our city, there are 20 sites and every site has 20 buildings for 5,000 people. And these buildings have 11 floors. There are three skyscrapers in our city, and each of them has 22 floors. We have one small airport and one bus terminal. Airport has two floors and bus terminal has only ground floor. There is one big city hospital you can see here with 5,000 beds. It has 8 floors. Also, in every structure, in every site, there is one health center and it only has a ground floor. We have 5 hotels for tourists close to the sea and each of them has 4 floors. You can see outside view of our hotels and this is the normal floor plan. There is one big shopping mall and it has 6 floors. We can see the design of the mall here. And also our city has 5 sport complexes and 3 culture centers. In our city, we have walkable streets and there is a total of 8 buildings lined up both sides of the street. And there are restaurants, cafes, markets, and shops. Also, we have a large city square that includes some important buildings. There are 3 factories where people can work. Each of them has 3 floors and we can see the design of the factory here.
Hello everyone, I am Mikhail. I will tell you about the transportation in our city. There are smart transportation systems in our city. Electric vehicles are generally preferred for environmentally friendly transportation. There is a smart application designed for each vehicle. Our city has an airport and a port and a bus terminal. Here we can see how the order on the route. And here we can see the transportation route of our city.
Hello everyone. I am Berke. Today I will continue. Today I will talk about quality management and the materials. Quality management. The manager just implemented the following activities to fulfill the requirements of this process. First, creating job descriptions of employees. Second, control and supervision of employees. Finally, in this project, as in any structure, we paid attention to quality because that was the most important thing and we have moved in that direction. Materials, site buildings. Reinforced concrete was used in the site buildings. You can see reinforced concrete in this photo. Skyscrapers, the river shown in the photograph was used in the skyscrapers. Hotels, clean and fine sand were also used in the construction of the walls of the hotel buildings. Hospital, we organized this in the green building format that we also use in some of our buildings. Factories, sedimentary stones were used in wall construction.
Hello everyone, now I will continue to our presentation with geotechnique. Geotechnique is a science that examines the soil behavior in general. In this section, I will give the information about the soil investigation results of the area where our city is located. We have determined all our decisions and examinations according to this suitable map. As is shown in this map, some of our area need improvement for settlement. Next page, please. In this slide, you can see the basic ground problems for settlement in our area, such as soft soil. Sand compaction piles is one of the improvement methods for soft soil. Sand compaction piles is used in order to compress the sand on the ground and increase the resistance. In addition to sand compaction piles, raft foundations can be used in this area to build a structure. And also liquefaction is one of the important ground problems we can encounter in this area. For this area, wood remote application need to be done, like drainage, or pile foundations can be used to transfer superstructure load from the weak ground to the deep solid. Thank you for listening.
Hi everyone, I am Enes. I will show the hydraulic system of our town. Smart infrastructure is a system that transmits, analyzes, and monitors data thanks to the sensor used in smart infrastructure. Intelligent transportation and communication technology components. Smart waste container system and smart irrigation system is an important component of smart infrastructure. In this photo, we see the smart irrigation system. In this system, you can park your vehicle where there is no traffic and pay your ticket automatically. In this photo is an example of this system. You can charge your electric vehicle in these areas. These areas will be in the parking lot of each site. In this system, our aim is to generate electrical energy from wastewater. The facility in this photo is the facility that provides this system.
There are state-of-the-art smart security systems for security in our city, such as smart cameras, smart lights, smart applications.
Hi everyone, after that I will continue presentation. Environmental status. Energy sources that we use for our city are solar energy, wave energy, and wind energy. In this slide, you can see the green building photo that we use in various parts of our city. Here you see our wave energy system and our shores. Energy resources map of our city. In this slide, you can see the application we have made to prevent air pollution. You can see the application we have made to prevent water pollution. Thank you for your attention.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, go ahead, please.
I'm wondering, why did they use green roof for building?
Because buildings, roads, and other types of typical urban infrastructure absorb heat, and they can make cities much more hotter than surrounding rural areas, and this caused the as you know, global warming. And that's why we use green roofs. I can say that.
Can I ask?
Go ahead.
Why did you choose to use JetCrowd for improvement?
What?
Why did you choose to use JetCrowd for improvement? I said.
Maybe I can answer this question. We choose to use jet ground improvements to prevent lateral movement of the ground on the liquid surfaces.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
I can have a question. Do you have an example when you designed the city?
When designing our city, we took the Danish town of Brandenburg as an example.
All right, if there is no more questions, maybe we will continue with the next group. And it appears that actually we will not be able to finish all groups today. So Some of the groups will continue their presentation maybe next week, and we will meet again at 1:30 and continue our presentations. Especially, I think there are a few groups that cannot make it today. So let's continue with the ones available. And then, as I said, time is not sufficient for us to finish all of them, and we will continue next week with some of the groups. Right. Now, let's proceed with the next one. Thank you very much.
The next joint venture is Bridge and Peak. By the way, you should give some grades on desk for these presentations. You know that. Okay.
You can see my screen, right?
Yes, we can see it.
Yeah.
Okay. Hello, everyone. I am Gazel. Today, I will talking about location needs and the purpose of the town and the financial planning. In this project, we design a town. Town where approximately 120,000 people can live in the area. We choose from the Istanbul Maltepe region. The department that work in our city design are structural, water resources and the hydraulics, geotechnical, environmental, transportation and the construction engineering and the management. Next slide, please. Location need and the purpose of the town. The study area is located in the Maltepe districts of the Istanbul province. The distance and the measurements of the region are shown in this picture. There are certain factors that make a city habitable. Some of these factors, low crime rate and the advanced security system, conveyance in the transportation, buildings in the city will be earthquake resistant. It appeals to the eye aesthetically and the social sufficient. In order to provide these factors as much as possible, we have conducted various studies under some heating. Some of these include smart city system, habitat regulation, and natural resource transformation. Next slide, please. Financial planning, budget, economic, and other consideration. There are several factors that affected the cost of the residential construction, one of which is classification of the structure. First, second, third grade construction, luxury construction, simpler procedural structure. Depending on the residential condition of the building, the square meter features of the structure vary. Construction costs are divided into two as the rough and the fine labor cost. These costs vary according to person's preferences and these physical condition of the structure. As many factors such as the material to be used, the condition of the roof, the number of the floors in the building play an important role in the budget. For example, increasing the number of the columns increases the cost of the construction. We made sure that there were all kinds of the buildings in our city and that they appeal to everyone. Thank you for listening to me. İrem will continue.
Hello everyone, I'm İrem. I will talk about design and construction planning and transportation. The overall design of the sub-district of our city is in the form of a high sun and inspired by the triumphal arc of the star. Our upper district is inspired by the Barcelona city plan. These city designs are uncompleted and visually appealing designs that will make life easier. Next slide, please. Our goals in the overall design of the town are to make life easier and provide people with large living spaces. We divided our city into two regions and designs. each area in line with the needs of the city. We designed more comfortable and useful areas by dividing residential areas in the sites. Next slide, please. Transportation. Our aim in transportation in our town was to prepare a transportation system that would not harm the environment and provide convenience to the people living in the city. Waterproof concrete and asphalt were used in areas suitable for the ground. Electric bus and tram system was used to minimize transport air pollution. Two-way bike paths have been added to certain streets and parks. A smart city system was used to manage the city, and a smart transport system was used to manage traffic and public transportation. Thank you for listening to me. Beyza, please continue.
Hello everyone, I'm Beyza. I'm going to talk about the geotechnic part. Raft foundation is used in residential buildings in the upper parts of the region. Raft foundation is the most suitable foundation type for apartment type high-rise buildings on weak grounds. The use of pile foundations in buildings near the coast has been deemed appropriate. As pile foundations are set in the soil, they are more tolerant to erosion and scour. All the residential buildings in this project are reinforced concrete carcass structures. The entire area of the study area is under the influence of a large fracture system, which is North Anatolian Fault. You can see in the first picture, extending in the east-west direction in the Marmara Sea, and that's why this area has high seismicity. In this project, it has been deemed appropriate to take earthquake ground motion level 2. In the drilling works carried out in the certain places in the work areas, research was conducted at a depth of 50 meters. Next slide, please. The geological formations covering the project area are Trakya, Kurtköy, Sürahyapaşa, and Sultanbeyli Altıntepe formations. For the field experiment, only the pressure meter experiment is done in the working areas. You can see it on the picture on the right. In the groundwater measurements in the study area, in the range of 4.5 to 5.0 meters to groundwater has been found, making necessary insulations to prevent damage to building foundations due to underground water effect is recommended. There is no need for examination in terms of liquefaction and soil swelling for the project area, so there is no need to soil improvements. During foundation excavation, taking excavation safety measures to prevent lateral deformations and ensure stability is mandatory. Thank you for listening to me. Aziz will continue.
Hello everyone, I am Aziz. I will talk about infrastructure system and environmental issues. We used a separate system in our city. The reason we use a separate system is that the wastewater and rainwater tunnels go to the treatment plant without mixing. As can be seen in the picture, wastewater tunnels and rainwater tunnels are separated. We designed the separate pipe to reach the wastewater treatment plant. We aim to use the treated water in the city. Untreated water and other substances will be discharged through pipes to a distant part of the sea. Since there is no place in our city where we can produce water, the water reaches the storage in our city through pipes from another city. From these storage, we deliver the water to all buildings in our city via steel and lead pipes. Next slide, please. We aim to design our city in a way that makes life easier. Some studies conducted in smart cities can have many effects, such as energy saving and making life easier. We designed our city as a smart city with smart transportation roads, smart information access, and smart security system projects. Since there will be traffic density in the city, we aim to provide sound insulation by making parks and afforestation close to every living space. We designed the coastal
that people can socialize. With wind turbines, which are a structure that produce electricity from wind energy, and we can meet some of our city's electricity from here. We aim to reduce water pollution, which is one of the biggest problems of the big cities, with our wastewater treatment plant. Thank you for listening to me. Now, Mohammed, to continue.
Hello everyone. I'm going to talk about construction and quality management and safety concerns. First slide about construction management. In construction management, we focused on ending unplanned urbanization in the region. We changed the existing urbanization structure of the region. We gradually increased the number of the floors, starting from the residential areas on the coast. In this way, we got rid of the distorted urbanization image. Just a minute. And second slide about the quality management. The first criterion we paid attention to when designing our city was the safety of people, of course. No matter how safe we design our buildings, the material used must be high quality and robust. For this reason, we must apply some material standards accepted in the world. In this table, you can see experimental behavior of concrete and steel used in the in our country after 2000 is shown. And next slide about the safety concerns. When designing the city, we tried to find simple and effective solution. Given the geological features of the area, we have listed the building shapes that shouldn't be made, especially because of the sloping multiple region. We stopped the designing layered buildings. Instead, we conducted geological surveys and built buildings on solid foundation. And as you can see in the picture, there are many buildings made of this type in our country and in the city of Maltepe. In the city of Maltepe, located in the earthquake zone, and we designed symmetrical and robust buildings to reduce of the effect of the earthquake. And next slide. As you can see in the previous slide, we tried to find simple effective solution. We listed the characteristic of the carrier system in this way. And the most important issue is vertical and horizontal loads should reach the base as soon as possible. You can see the picture. And we finished our presentation. Actually, we try to presentation to our city, and we designed the simple and reliable city. Thank you for listening to us.
I have a question.
Go ahead, please.
What is the reason you choose this area?
I can answer this question. The fact that the region is seaside and suitable for design has been a factor to choosing this region.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Any more questions? Well, in that case, I have a question. You say there is no need for liquefaction analysis. I wonder why.
Yes, sorry, Professor.
Mohammed, some job checks.
I think Beyzanur, you showed it, I think.
Okay. Soil is rock soil, so there is no need for examination That's why.
Okay, okay, thank you. Any more question?
Can I ask, Professor?
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
What was the hardest thing in this project for you?
So who is answering? Yaren?
Repeat the question.
What was the hardest thing in this project for you, the plan or design or financial problems?
Okay, I think this project financial planning is very difficult, in my opinion.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right, we thank you. And let's proceed with the next presentation. And it appears that, as I said, during the last period, we cannot finish all the presentations today. Some of the groups will make presentations next week. One of them will be John Tulin. The other one be Skyscraper, Molo's Brick, and DNM BNKM joint ventures. They will make their presentations next week. And now we will continue with the current ones. I think the next one is October, Steely joint venture.
No, Professor, 3M and Green.
Oh, okay, we missed that one. All right, let's continue with that one.
Açıldı mı? Ekran geldi mi?
No, we couldn't see anything. We cannot see anything.
Bende gözüküyor ama.
Still we cannot see.
Bir dakika hocam. Şimdi geldi mi?
No.
Şevval, istersen ben paylaşayım, sen başla. Öyle yapalım. Şu an gözüküyor mu ekran?
Yes, we can see it.
Bunu nasıl şey yapacağım bilmiyorum. Slide haline getireceğim.
Başladım. Şevval,
Today, as Green and 3M company, we will introduce our city to you. The name of our city is Quartz City. Next page. We built it in Darja Kocaeli. It has 24 square kilometers of surface, more than 100,000 houses on the surface.
Sorry. Wait a minute.
Üçüncü sayfet.
Wait a minute. Cool. Yes. Now we can continue.
We aim to build more livable city that create solution that add value to life by using the latest technology and innovative approaches. Kocaeli province is located on an important earthquake forming and tectonic belt. Next page. The Darja region is located on 6 fault lines due to seismic hazard, its primary earthquake zone. Next page. Structural steel is known for its ductility, extremely popular in skyscraper and earthquake resistant buildings. Reinforced concrete is used in conjunction with structural steel to create earthquake and cyclone resistant buildings. Earthquake early warning is real-time detection of an earthquake that might cause damage at the closest location to its source and generating a warning signal. Structural integrity of building can be strengthened with cross steel supports that frame the outside of a build in an X shape. Next page. Seismic-based isolation system is flexible approach to isolate the structure from the ground and reduce the spread of seismic shock to structure. Seismic isolation can be significantly reduce building shaking. Now Yiğit will continue.
Okay. Can you see my screen and my face? Okay. Now. The next is, wait a minute, the city center. We draw this bird's eye picture with a design team. We designed the city center for about 50,000 people to live in the city center. And in this center, there is a hospital, a museum, a glass tower, art gallery, schools, hospitals, fire departments, police stations, and we designed a 1.5 square kilometer green area in the city center. You can see this because the people can get rid of the stress of the daily life and they can get fresh air during their breaks at the works. And the next one is the 3D of the city center. We did in the Paint 3D program. Now I'm going to give some basic definition about the significant structures. The hospital. The hospital was built on of a 0.5 square kilometer area. The hospital is designed a fully equipped hospital, and it has a 1,200 beds and a 15 type of concrete was used in our hospital because our area is on the earthquake area. And 859 seismic isolators are used in each column. The next one is City Hall. City Hall is located in the city center of, it was built on a 0.04 square kilometer area in a very aesthetic manner with the four floors. And C14 type concrete was used in the City Hall. State of suitable concrete are used. It's an organic concrete building material was used. It means the government supported to organic materials and protect nature. The next one is a fire department. I did these structures in the SketchUp programming. I add this building and this pool, this garden, and it's located on the of 0.005 square kilometer area. The pool is in the garden, and debris, rubble, crabs, cars, and the firefighters will be able to get training ready for any negative event that may occur. The building bricks are used lighter and more efficient bricks that called cigarette butts. And the next one is as for facilities. In this center, we have three full equipment support facilities and two of the residential areas. And the C45 type concrete was used during the construction. And each support areas is 0.07 square kilometer. And we use light producing cement. And the next one is schools. Schools were built on of 0.02 square kilometer areas. There are one in residential areas and two in the city center. The next one is a glass tower. This is the city's landmark. Its area on the 0.003 square kilometer. And this is shining of the in middle of the city. The glass are used to produce with the smart glass technology. The purpose of the building is a host of art exhibitions, painting, fashion, and books, etc. The next one are houses. We designed like this, like Barcelona. And we have in a high school, a primary school, a middle school, and a health clinic in our houses areas. This is the 3D picture, our houses. And approximately 20,000 people live in our residence in Begonville. This is our Begonville. And we have another one, 15,000 people living in a Nergis neighborhood, like a Nergis. It's a Turkish name. We have 1,000 house in the Begonville area and 750 house in the Nergis area. We use C40 type concrete in houses because we have an earthquake danger. And that's it. And the industrial area, we want to make a city which is producing and consume what they did. And we choose the industrial area near the harbor. We have a harbor and we want to, it's far away from the residence area, but it should be close to city center. And we use 3D technology to make these factories. And our city is famous for the olive and it's really close to, how can I say, we have a Turkish car factory, you know, it's a TOK. We want to make an automobile factory in our city. And we have a ferry harbor, and we have a ferry factory, ceramic factory, wagon factory, and a tire factory, because we have train stations. And the next one is a seaside. The Darija is a seaside city. There is a water sports area in our seasides, outdoor sports fields, and a hobby garden, playgrounds, concert areas. 6 kilometer long and 1.2 square kilometer area in our seasides. The next one is a stadium. Stadium is has a name, a Yakamo Stadium, which is the one of the symbol of our city. And this stadium take name from the moonlight grove in the sea in the evenings. And 42,000 spectator capacity has this stadium. And this stadium is 0.11 kilometer square. And it was built on the of 0.20 square meters. And the next one is a courthouse. Now you can continue, Duygu.
I will talk about other important buildings in our city. The courthouse is located in the center of our city and has an area of 60 acres, consisting of two interconnected blocks. One block of this building has 3 floors and the other block has 5 floors. Next, please. Museum and art gallery. Both buildings are in the center of our city. Museum has a total area of 30,000 square meters, as open and closed areas. Art gallery has an area of 18,000 square meters. Both buildings have three floors, and there are many exhibition and conference halls in both buildings. Next page. The shopping center has an area of 80,000 square meters and is also located in the center. Next, please. Our city has a peninsula, and there are villa sites in this peninsula. Each villa is 100 square meters, two floors, and there are 300 villas in total. Each villa has its own pool, and also villas have communal ponds. Next, please. We have a university campus close to the sea in our city. The campus covers a total area of 50,000 square meters. There are many faculties and green areas on the campus. Esma, you can continue.
I will explain about hydraulic. The science of fluid under pressure, its mechanical properties, behavior using force transmission, fluid motion and control is referred to in hydraulics. Hydraulics usage area is very common. In the city we designed, we made a lot of using hydraulic sub-branch because it's a port. While designing our part, we considered land and sea connections, loading, unloading equipment, and development plans. A wide variety of transportation can be private from the port. For instance, transportation by cargo ships can be done very easily from here. With ferry boats, the locals of the city can easily get around. In our city, we designed wind panels as seafront settlements. We determined the most appropriate location and type by complying with our annual energy production targets. Next slide. Infrastructure systems. Infrastructure engineering. It designs, plans, and inspects construction and infrastructure construction such as road, bridge, dam, and irrigation projects, water and sewage systems. One of the most important infrastructure system in the sewage system. In order for water-related services to be successful, the operating phase must be planned and managed very well. Successful installation of a sewer system operation depends on the following factors. Firstly, the system should only carry wastewater of the type it was designed for during its physical life. For instance, intended to be discharged to sewer systems, industrial wastewater can only be brought to be designed standard, then it should be allowed to discharge into the system. In this picture, we can see the canalization driving of the Arst Center and industrial zone. Next slide. Geotechnics. Geotechnical scientific methods and engineering principles are the acquisition, estimation, and application of the informed soil layer and its recurrent properties in this other engineering problem. There is not even a single engineering structure that is not related to the ground. Housing, school, hospital, dam, port, various water structure, bridge, hike bay, railway, or airport, etc. In short, all kinds of engineering structure made to meet the natural needs of human beings sit on the ground or is also the ground. Therefore, while we were designing our city, we did a lot of research about the ground by investigating whether the building are compatible with the ground. The ground in the first picture, industrial zone. The ground in the industrial zone is the best ground for our region. So we have kept the volume of factories there and increased the revenue. Last picture is classification
location of ground. Next slide. Environmental issues. The certification, depletion of biodiversity, deforestation, destruction of the ozone layer, acid rains, air, water, and soil pollution, hazardous wastes, depletion of natural resources, marine and ocean pollution, acidification of the ocean stand out among global environmental.
Ismanur, we have to speed up a bit because we are running out of time.
Bitti mi burada?
Yeah, let's.
Bitti benim şey. Kız.
Okay.
Tamam. We can continue.
Onur, please be brief because we are running out of time. Okay.
Okay, teacher. Since human safety is important in our city, no savings have been made. Everything is made using quality materials. Cost of buildings, cost of workers, seismic isolator, infrastructure, and lighting are calculated from the beginning. The cost from the first to the last stage of the construction of our city, 20.8 million Turkish lira. Transportation has been created on the basis of developing technology and renewability. Smart and solar powered roads are an important point for the developing electric vehicle revolution. The solar energy stored by the roads provides electrical energy while driving in the vehicle with critical collapse. So we both reduce the load on the charging station and actively use renewable energy, smart and solar powered roads. They have taken precautions for the traffic problem in the developing cities in advance. These measures are multi-storied car parks in the busy parts of the city. We try to encourage people to walk and cycle rather than make them depend on driving. Thanks for listening to us.
Thank you. Let's have the questions.
Can I ask a question?
Go ahead, please.
What is the purpose of glass tower?
I can answer. As I told, the purpose of the building is to host art exhibitions, a painting exhibition, a fashion exhibition, and a books exhibition, because we really take care of the art and sport. And we have museum also and the art galleries. I think it's enough.
Can I ask a question?
Go ahead, please.
Why did you choose to put wind tunnels in the sea?
Because we want to generate more energy and to get rid of noise of wind panels.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
What is your most important work in transportation in your city?
I think it could be to contribute to developing electric vehicle regulation.
Thank you.
All right, let's proceed with the next presentation.
October and Stili joint venture.
Hocam bir yanlışlık oldu galiba. Jontil'in var 6. sırada.
No, we skip them because one of their members is missing.
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Go ahead, please.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. In this presentation, we will give you brief information about the city that we have built. Here you can see the topics that we will talk about in this presentation. First, we have determined an area where we will realize our project. Interested in civil engineering sub-branches, and we have made researches by considering the region we have chosen. After conducting our research, we came together and other sub-disciplines that we will work with and exchanged ideas and continued our studies. Finally, we came together and we placed our structures on our map. This is the plan of our map. You can see the buildings that we built on the map. And there's a legend. Location, need, and purpose of the town. Gotham is a city established with the latest technology on the Asian side of Istanbul. The reason we chose Kadıköy for reconstruction is that the area is an earthquake zone. The area needs a city plan and people are not safe here. Also, Gotham provides its people with a healthy, safe, and socializing environment. In the table on this page, you can see how much we spent on which building and the total cost. The budget that we determined for the city was 30 billion Turkish liras, and we were able to build the city without exceeding the budget.
Hello everyone, I will talk about design and construction planning of Gotham City. First, design of Gotham City. Our first goal was to design an environmentally friendly and modern city. While designing the city, we took Barcelona architecture as an example. I think everyone knows that Barcelona is one of the best places in the world about architecture. In this way, unplanned urbanization did not occur place in our city. Our public transportation vehicles pass almost every point of the city. In this way, the use of individual vehicles has decreased and therefore the damage to environment has also decreased. We built the industry zones outside the city. We built a large city hospital in the center of the city. We also paid attention to socialization in the city. We should also mention that Gotham is located in earthquake zone. That's why we use seismic isolators in all our buildings. Next. Next slide, please. Millie. Millie, can you hear me?
I can hear you. I skipped.
I don't see. Construction planning of Gotham City. First, we examined the soil structure of our region with the engineers in our company. We made the project drawing and plan of each building. Although we were faced with serious problems, we finished all projects on time thanks to good employees in our company. Thank you, my friends. We will continue.
Geotechnical engineering. Next page, please. What is geotechnical engineering? It is a department that started to form in the early 1900s and is important to solving civil engineering problems. Geotechnical, it works for the ergonomic and safe creation every structure that will be built on the ground. It is the sub-branch of engineering that deals with the interactions between the soil or rock environment in which structures are placed. Next page, please. When we from a wider environment, it is seen the geotechnical studies consist of three main elements. The factors we mentioned, soil mechanics, analyzing the engineering properties and behavior of the soil, foundation construction, the development of engineering design to solve application problems, soil dynamics, investigation of the engineering properties of soil and their behavior under dynamic loads. Next one, please. How is the ground survey done? The geological and geotechnical properties of soil for which the soil survey required or desired is determined. Samples are taken by drilling works in the field, and samples are sent to universities and companies for analysis. Soil investigation report is created by evaluating the obtained data. Next one, please. Which information is reached during the ground survey? Groundwater level increases the intensity of the earthquake, ground safety, regression, reduction, and examination of the liquefaction potential. Ground safety regression to prevent deformation on the ground and to keep the horizontal load of the earthquake at an optimum level. Next one, please. Next page, please. Buildings, we need the ground survey before starting construction in Gotham. Hotel, museum, place of worship, post office, justice palace, police station, and theater. Next page, please. Next one, quality management. It has four main components: quality planning, quality assurance, quality control, quality improvement. Thank you for listening to me.
Okay, hello everyone. Now it's my turn. I'm going to talk about the transportation. You can hear me, right?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay. It's a system of movement of a person from one location to another easily. It could be public or private. It must be managed on a schedule by authorities, and it's operated on established routes. Next one, please. It's important to provide mobility and helps people to access their jobs. So in the business, to stakeholders such as other businesses, customers, and suppliers. The connectivity provided by transportation gives social inclusion to the people, and people can reduce the gas emission if they take public transportation. And finally, it helps to grow economy, provides easy accessibility to markets, hospitals, or colleges. There are four essentials of transportation, and those are coverage, coordination, long-term funding, and local funding. In this slide, you can see our transportation network in our city and the transportation facilities to reach the essential places such as hospital, university, and shopping mall. Next slide. And the economy and livability of cities depends on their transportation infrastructure. If the transportation systems are qualified, people's lives become more livable. And to develop and serve a qualified and useful transportation, we go for the newest and modern technology. We use newest public vehicles such as electric vehicles, autonomous subway and bus, and Hyperloop technology. And finally, safety concerns. As in every city, there may be artificial and natural security problems in our city, Gotham. You should take precautions against these problems. On the basis of these are police stations, prisons, courts, and precautions that should be in every city. There are many examples of natural security problems, such as insulators in buildings, thermal soil improvement in areas where soil is problematic, and so on. Our working area consists of partly weathered stones. This shows that structures on such ground are in danger. That's why we didn't build too many buildings in these areas. We made sure that the buildings we built were not very high rise. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I am Taha. I will continue. Environmental engineering is the branch of engineering that is concerned with protecting people from the effects of adverse environmental effects, such as pollution, as well as improving environmental quality. Environmental engineers works to improve recycling, waste disposal, public health, and water and air pollution control. According to United States Bureau of Labor Statistics. Next page. A green building is a building that, in its design, construction, or operation, reduce or eliminate negative impacts and can create positive impacts on our climate and natural environment. Green buildings preserve precious natural resources and improve our quality of life. Rainwater coming from the roof or rain gutter in each building is collected and filtered and made ready for use in necessary works. Drip irrigation system is used to save water in gardening areas or buildings. An insulation system is made to protect the buildings from hot weather in summer and cold weather in winter. Instead of natural gas, an electric floor heating system is used to heat buildings. Solar energy is used by using solar collectors to provide hot water to buildings. With the insulating glass system, which is produced by using materials with low toxicity rates in buildings, but the cold coming from outside is prevented and the sunlight enters and warms up without the reflection from the heat glass. Construction management. Every structure was made in the most appropriate way. Every structure was made in the healthiest way. All kinds of security measures are taken. Thanks for listening to me.
Notes, are you there?
Yeah, I was talking, sorry for that. I will talk about environmental issues and water resource. Environmental problems emerge with the rapidly increasing world population and plant industrialization and mechanization, increased use of pesticides, artificial fertilizers, and chemicals. While environmental problems destroy the natural structure of the areas where people live, polluted air, water, and soil have reached a level that can negatively affect the lives of all living things. And our innovations for the solution of environmental problems. We have created an effective environmental control system. We increased the number of non-governmental organizations to solve environmental problems. We created planned city areas instead of unplanned urbanization. We ensured the reproduction and protection of forests. We created neat and environmentally friendly industrial zones. We worked on sorting garbage at its source and installed the necessary facilities. We ensured the use of quality fuels. And water resources. Water is vital in human life. Water is not only a necessary object for life, it is life itself. It is the place where the first life on Earth began. And the surrounding nature is a very valuable element that has no substitute for the life of mother and living things. Therefore, the value of water is known by our city. And our aim in this project, design, construction, and operation of all structures related to water resource engineering, water use, control management, and operation. And we choose gravity dump for our town because gravity dumps are a concrete or masonry dump and are designed to hold back water by balancing only the horizontal water pressure pushing the weight of the material and its strength towards the foundation. Gravity dumps are built to withstand the strongest earthquakes, which is the main reason we choose this type of dump in our project. Major problems that water resources engineering may face. Today, it is known that the situation of groundwater resources has worsened both in terms of quantity and quality in some regions of our countries in the world. However, these resources must be protected, especially as they interact and fit at the surface. Groundwater bodies should be determined first, then the characterization process showing the natural structure of groundwater system. Within the scope of operational monitoring factors that put the mass at risk should be clearly defined. Threshold values of pollutant groups should be determined and status assessment should be made. Then in conclusion, we have designed a small city for the world, but a big city for us by working with the sub-branches of civil engineering. With our six friends in our project, while designing the city, our aim was to offer a lifestyle in which people's health, life and property safety, sociality, education and culture are at the center. We think that we have designed the closest key to this with what we have learned so far and the research we have done. One of the few things we learned during the project is that the distribution of tasks can affect the project as well as have negative consequences for human life. Thank you, Professor and friends.
Well, any questions?
I think it was very clear, teacher, professor.
Well, anyway, I think, okay, then I'll ask question. Well, you mentioned a dam construction for this town, and I wonder, do we have enough water resources?
I don't think we have, but our environmental issues we are reproductioning, I think. We are saving water.
In your budget document, I noticed that you put $4.1 million for Turkish dam, if you recall that, for a dam construction.
Yeah, we didn't notice that actually.
Okay, I think that's
I have a question. What is the most important thing for you about water resources?
I think it was the dam, and it was about our people, because we have to save water to involve everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're welcome.
You know, you have to consider that construction caused some environmental problems as well. Oh, well, I think we have to stop here because we have other courses, lectures. And for the remaining of the presentations, we will continue next Tuesday at the same time, 1:30. And the presenting groups will be there, of course, but also other members of the class who already presented are supposed to be there. Okay, so we will meet next week, Professor, Tuesday at 1:30.
Sunum puanlamalarını biz yükleyemiyoruz, bilginiz olsun. Yine geçen seferki gibi oldu yine.
Hayır, güncelledim ben onu, üstüne yenilemeniz lazım.
Tamamdır hocam, teşekkürler.
Okay, thank you. Don't forget to score the presentations. And I thank you, all of you, and I congratulate you. I think you learned a lot during the process. And as I said, we will continue the presentations next week. Take care, and I hope to see you next week. Continue our presentations regarding TURN Project 2, the town of my dreams. You remember, in this project, actually, you will choose a development area in Istanbul or Kocaeli, and then by using all topographic maps of the area and other information, you will work with the most modern construction technology and materials, and then actually you will design and construct your town of dreams. And then you will you worked on that more than a month, and then I think you had very good ideas for the design of your dream town, let's say. Now you are going to present your dreams and your information about the structures, design. This may be related to foundation, energy, environment, all different topics. And you spend quite a bit of time on this, and now it is time to present your results, actually your dreams here. And with that, we can proceed our presentations. Now the first presentation, you said Ondelin. Okay, let's go Yiğit.
Okay. Can you see my screen now?
Yes, we can see.
Hello everyone. As Jontulin and XAEA12, we chose Kocaeli Gölcük region to set our town, and we try to make it attractive and also economically self-sufficient with most appropriate methods. First, I'm going to give a brief information about geotechnical engineering. Geotechnical engineers research and study soils to evaluate its suitability for foundations. They investigate and assess construction sites, and then they write reports and present them. It is the map of our region. As you can see, our town separated three parts here, let's say. These parts have more stronger soil type than the middle part of Gölcük. So we focus on the west and south part to build structures. We determined to build factories on eastern side of map to make our town economically self-sufficient. Also, these are some 3D symbolic models of our town. There is geological map of Gölcük. Gray locations are alluvial soil type. If it's compared, alluvial soil has less bearing capacity than other five types of soil types because of its clay and sandy particles. And alluvial thickness is generally increasing when you go to east part of Gölcük. Now let's talk about problems may occur on our land and what we did to prevent them. Three major problems we detected: soil liquefaction, swelling of soil, and landsliding. Swelling soils are ones that swell in volume when subjected to moisture. This situation results in structural damage on buildings. In this case, for purpose of supporting the structural loss, we use deep foundation in order to isolate the structure and prevent uplift from swelling between the pile and ground beam. A void is supplied. Floors are then constructed as floating slabs. Second one is soil liquefaction. Soil liquefaction is when layers lose their strength temporarily and act like a liquid instead of solid. We use superjet grout technique for this problem. And the last one is landsliding. Most of our structures built on hills, so we have to stabilize soil, and we chose anchoring technique to stabilize soil.
I'm Muhammed Ali Turuç. I will talk about the structural engineering. Structural engineering is a branch of civil engineering that examines structure system design and structural analysis. Let's evaluate our project in terms of structure. In the region, we have identified shopping centers, circle factory, hospital, apartment building, library varying between 4 and 8 stories was built. School, hospital, factory type buildings were also built in the same form in the other region. Let's talk about these structures. Next page. School, our 4-story schools with a capacity of thousands and an area of 10,000 square meters are located in the city center and its surrounding. There are 23 classrooms with completely digital and projecting systems. Our schools have a seismic isolator system, dielectric sensor are available. Next page, hospital. We have 80-story 450-bed 100,000 square meters hospital in the city center, and the car park for visitors is located in the basement of the hospital. There are also accommodation places of various comfort classes for healthcare personnel. The hospital structure is designed as a modern, technological, and contemporary looking structure. Next page. Residence. Houses are located in inner parts of the city as a performance within the complex. Due to the weak soil, the deep foundation tip base was used. Each house with an area of 8 square meter site varies between 3-7 floors. If we talk about structures, automatic garden irrigation, climate control gas system that provide heat control in windows, and more.
Hello, I will talk about the management part. But since there are some misinterpretations, I will talk about the urban management part that is not really included in the project instead of the construction management part. When we heard that we were going to design a town with 100,000 inhabitants in the project, we looked into what this area would need and offer. We came across interestingly large numbers about educational, medical, and other services needed. For example, as you can see on the table, it turns out that if we gather so many people together, we need to give the region nearly 22 million liters of water daily, and that was not all we had to provide. All this data is a guide for the services to be offered in our region. Next page, please. As mentioned in the ground structure, the north part is not strong enough. Therefore, the majority of the population will be distributed to the hills in the eastern and western regions. The western region was planned as the majority inhabited and commercial area, the eastern region as a settlement oriented, and the northern region as a production region. Then we ask ourselves the following question: why will the 100,000 people stay here? Of course, the answer is money. We realized that we had to provide some opportunities. To keep so many people in the area, we built an industrial zone in the east of the north area. Since we are by the sea, we built a fishing cove and shipyard. In addition, we decided to build a port in order to transport the products of our industrial area and neighbor cities. Next page, please. And let's talk a little bit about the environment. When we examine the region, one of the biggest disadvantages of the region is that it's in a very high-risk earthquake zone. This situation greatly affected the settlement and structures of the city. Another problem is the renewable energy resource potential of the region. Our first option to use was solar energy. When we look at the map at the top left, you can see that the annual solar energy potential of the region is low. This situation directed us to wind energy. When we examined the annual wind speed of the region, we saw that the wind speed with maximum efficiency can be obtained for only 9 days in a year. In addition, the fact that there are bird communities living in the surrounding areas has distracted us from this solution. For this reason, the energy requirement was provided by natural gas, which is less environmentally friendly. Thanks for listening to me.
Hello there, I am Alp. I will talk about the work done on the hydraulic branch in the region. First of all, what is hydraulic? It's a hydraulic science and is concerned with water. It is also one of the sub-branches of civil engineering. Next page. The region we have chosen is rich in water resources. There is a bay in the north and two lakes in the northeast and southwest. It is also very rich in terms of underground. Next page. Since the river resources on the surface were insufficient, we thought of using groundwater and we built a dam underground. This dam has a capacity of treating 30,000 cubic meters of water per day. Next page. The water treatment plant has its own resources in the region where it is located. In this region, 6,000 cubic meters of water can be treated per day. Wastewater will be collected and recycled in the wastewater treatment plant. 6,000 cubic meters of water will be recycled daily in this facility. Next page. In this table, we talk about water tanks. Next page. We thought of building a port and shipyard for the development of trade and economy in our city. Our port is 460,000 square meters. The shipyard is 45,000 square meters with open and closed area. Next page. In this picture, it is a sketch of the distribution line. Thank you for listening. Efsun, it's your turn.
Hi everyone, I'm Efsun and let's talk about transportation part. There are water resources in the mountain part. We wanted to make transportation easier for those who live and work there. They work very similar to the way elevators work. Next page, please. Let's talk about materials. We mentioned some of them as you can see. It is consists of posts, silver rope, dry wheel, and real batteries. The cost of the cable cars is 15 million Turkish liras. Next page, please. Also, we want to build a bridge. The main purpose of building bridge is to make it easier for those who work outside the district. The bridge is in the Haludere, as you can see the first photo. Second one is a model from SketchUp, which we have made it. Next page. To sum up, cost of the bridge is 12.9 billion Turkish liras. Next page. We thought the city needed a subway, but we should point out that it was a bit challenging due to the poor quality floors. Next page. We were careful about the water and electricity lines that will reach the city from under the mountains. To addition, subway line construction cost is like 2 billion Turkish liras. Thank you.
Okay, let's have the questions.
Can I ask a question?
Go ahead, please.
I think your school capacity is huge. Why did you build such a school which has high capacity?
Since our district is not big enough, we try to keep the number of schools to supply the needs of our town to minimum. It's the answer of your question.
Thank you.
Okay, any more questions? Okay, Cheval, can we ask a question, please? Cheval Ibiş. So she's not there. Okay, Cheval, I can see you raise your hand. Go ahead. We cannot hear you.
Sesim gelmiyor mu hocam?
Ha, şimdi now we can hear. Now we can hear. Sorry. What was your question?
Why did you choose here?
Because of its challenging location, let's say, and there are lots of soil type we evaluate, and we try to change settlement because today it's really wrong. They settled coastline, we changed it, and we settled on hills. We tried to change.
Okay.
Thank you
for the presentations and questions. Now we can proceed with the next one.
Construction
Silva
joint venture.
Hello everyone. Me and my teammates have created a habitat for 100,000 people in Avcılar region. Despite globalization and reinforced concrete in our region, we have brought nature to the forefront. Since the area is in an earthquake risk zone, we have established hundreds of gathering areas and taken all measures to protect human lives.
Location, need and purpose of the town. Location of the town, Avcılar. Purpose of the town, town planning and social areas. While designing the city, our aim was to highlight the green areas built around residential areas where social areas stand as well as the need for shelter. A square was built in the middle of the city. The city is spread over four main divisions. A concept where people can spend time on the beach has been issued by building and marina in the coastal area. Working areas and treatment facilities were built in the part of the city close to the lake, thus keeping them away from the residential areas. Financial planning, economic and other considerations. The total cost of the project was 7,740,000,000 liras.
This project, we select and use our materials in accordance with the standards so that the buildings we build do not turn into disasters. Cement, we choose ordinary Portland cement, which is the standard and most common type of cement. Concrete plays a huge role in a structure. We achieve integrity in the building by using the right type of concrete in the right places. We build our structures with reinforced concrete. We use self-compacting concrete in hard-to-reach parts or where we cannot use vibrators. Also, we use high-density concrete because it provides good protection from X-rays and radiation in radiotherapy places in hospital. Metal. Corrosion is the biggest enemy of metal when it comes to longevity, but effective corrosion control can make metal one of the best building materials. We use metal in reinforcement, building exteriors, and decoration. Glass. Of course, we use glass in our project. One of the properties of glass is 100% recyclable. Waste glass chips are used as a raw material in a glass production and as aggregate in concrete production. We built four schools in our project. Our kindergarten is designed for children's development. Then we gather primary and secondary schools under one roof. In high school, we built buildings in the middle of the field for increase the interaction between students. Finally, our university is a technical university, which puts special emphasis on research and education in engineering.
Residential site. We design each floor to have 6 apartments. We use transparent solar panels that contribute to energy production in glasses. We have added lightning rods to each building so that in the event of a lightning strike, the buildings will get the least damage. Next page. Public library. We use transparent solar panels in the public library as we did on the residential site. We prefer to use wood and glass as exterior material. Mosque. We prefer to use a modern design in the construction of the mosque. The material length of the dome is 35 meters.
Hospital. It is located centrally accessible to everyone. We designed hospital consisting of 3 departments with a total bed capacity of about 1,400. Foundation studies were carried out using the wet spread mixing method. Let me talk a little about the WSM method. The wet spread mixing method stands for a fast soil mixing procedure. The WSM is an alternative to conventional shoring and foundation methods such as king pile walls, sill-shaped pile walls, or the jet grating walls. High strength concrete and heavyweight concrete were used. Transportation. We considered how important transportation is when designing the city, and we worked as much as possible to avoid traffic congestion. City traffic direct around the single roundabout, and privileges were given to the public transport. We did things to direct people to public transportation, like the tram and special public transport lanes, because we know that people like fast transportation. Sound and water absorption feature and longer service life were considered when we choose material.
Marina, you can see the structure that should be in the four anchor marina in the drawing. The values indicated in the drawing are calculated according to the largest yacht to enter the harbor. The yacht length has been taken as 30 meters. In the researches, it has been calculated that 4-meter waves can hit the shores of the Avcılar. That's why the breakwater was built as 4 meters, organized industrial area. Concrete structure, BS25 class concrete, building foundation system, raft foundation, working areas. The single stories building was built to make the working areas more air and provide equal sunlight everywhere. And a more social space was obtained by allowing the workers to be on one floor.
Waste water treatment plant. We use STC 42.5R cement type. C2025, C3037, which is the most resistant to pressure and chemical, was used as concrete class. C3545 sulfur resistant concrete is
type is used in some of our buildings. We use plastic in our pipes and 316L type spiral welded stainless steel pipes in some of our pipes. Our treatment facility is at the lowest place in the region in terms of height because we keep the energy cost secured for pumping to a minimum. We use hollow filters and surface filters in our facility.
Public installations. We designed 6 public installations in triangular shape with the same project and combined them to form a hexagon. In this hexagon, there are notary, population directorate, governorship, municipality, tax office, and land registry directorate. Quality management. Urban air population is a major problem worldwide in both developed and developing countries. The solution is watching air quality. The main goal of any urban air quality management plan is to ensure that the impact of air population on human health remains minimal. Thanks to the solutions we found, it was found that the health conditions of people in the city we established were better than in the country in general.
Construction management. First, we completed legal proceedings for the right to zoning, and then we examined the soil structure of the regions where we will make the structures, and then we started to build the structures according to the results. The first buildings we started to build were residential buildings, and then we started to build hospitals and educational institutions. And then we started to build industrial zone buildings. When we have the construction, we continued with the water treatment plant. Finally, we built the cultural building. Safety concerns. As you can see from the map, Avcılar is at a very high risk of earthquakes. So we use seismic isolators to prevent the damage of earthquakes. Next page. Seismic isolators. There are many types of seismic isolators. As you can see from the figure, we use 2 different seismic isolators.
Environmental issues. We have developed an integrated waste management strategy in our city, thus minimizing our waste and ensuring that it is separated into source. We built the factory and treatment plant in our urban park from the residential area. We reduced noise and odor pollution. We made sound insulation in our homes.
Conclusion. There are many criteria when designing and implementing a city. We designed and built all our structures in a way that best suits these criteria. Along with this, we have acted by highlighting nature and human health. Thank you for participation. If you have any question, we try to answer them.
Well, thank you. Let's have the questions.
Can I ask a question?
Go ahead, please.
What was the most challenging building for you?
Shall I answer?
What was the most challenging building for you?
Okay, I understand. We think it's a hospital because we made a very detailed report about that because there are so many procedures when designing the hospital, since the hospital is a very basic need, and we try to do everything to the best.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, any more questions?
Teacher, I can ask a question.
Go ahead, please.
Why did you choose Avcılar? As I know, Avcılar is a very risky place about earthquake. Then why did you choose this place?
Did you hear the question?
Yes.
Shall I answer again?
Okay, maybe some other person in your group can answer.
Okay.
We give every person an opportunity to answer, maybe.
Okay.
Thank you, Batuhan. Who can answer in your group?
I can answer, teacher.
Go ahead, please.
We choose it because it is a region close to the lake and the sea. We made our solution against earthquake.
Okay, I see. Thank you.
Okay. If there is no more question, we can continue with the next one.
The next joint venture is Skyscraper and MFP.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, I'm sharing my screen.
Go ahead, please.
Can you see it?
Mm-hmm. Yes, we can see.
Okay, hello everyone. I'm Harun Can Mesci and we are Skyscraper and MFP. Today we are going to talk about how we redesigned Kadıköy. In this presentation, we will talk about its location, construction, structures, environmental issues, quality management and safety concerns about Kadıköy. So let's start with basics. As we all know, Kadıköy is hazardous area for buildings, and our aim is to make the safest structures. But we will avoid building multi-stories because of the fault lines. I will talk about that later. And Kadıköy is on the soft sail. And if we want to build multi-story structures, we will use seismic isolators to locate the fault lines. And we know Kadıköy is a crowded city, and the roads and the different roads is made for different type of cars. And for this, we will make a bicycle trail for the entire coast. And we will put solar panels and structures for the roadsides to produce more energy and electric for our city. For its geological location, Kadıköy is 25.20 square kilometers. And Kadıköy is on the Anatolian side of Istanbul. For its location, it's very important for the other provinces. And it's surrounded by multiple districts in the east, Bosphorus in the west, and Marmaris in the west, Üsküdar and Ateşehir districts in the north. Thus, Kadıköy can communicate more easily with the other provinces and districts. In this way, we can use our ports for transportation and goods. And we have many parks, such as Fenerbahçe and Göztepe Park. Thanks to those green spaces, the public can easily find living spaces and meet their needs in the park facilities we have built for them. And also, these facilities and energies are pursued by our solar systems in the coast.
Hi everyone, I am Muhammed Emin. I will talk about financial planning, budget, economic and other considerations. Since our district is located in an earthquake zone, we used high quality materials as possible in every building, which resulted in high cost. The total cost of residences in our district was 6 billion TL. The total cost of the hospital was 174 million TL. The total cost of the schools was 136 million TL. The total cost of the places worship 72 million TL. The total cost of the mining service building was 750 million TL. as we use seismic isolator in every structure, an additional cost of 357 million telewatts in Cairo, including the cost of infrastructure, transportation, environment, and other structures. The approximate cost of our strat was 24 billion TL. Murat will continue. Ulaş.
Sorry. Thank you, Mohamed. I am Ulaş. Design and construction plan. Water resources. For Kubal Creek, we will bring water from Kadıköy Dam as a reduce the water resources other places to return other stream. Then we will set up water treatment stages around Kadıköy Dam. Irrigation, flood control and industrial water supply. While using a small portion of water is irrigation, we continue to meet other requirements. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Bülent. I will talk about transportation plan in Kadıköy. Yes, Kadıköy central location and density of urban service because of it, it is located in the center of transportation links. Transportation and collective service for road, sea, rail systems Kadıköy district land slope where transportation models can be found when constant from point of view. Suitable for bicycle transportation in Istanbul. It's one of the few districts. In order to increase and popularize the use of bicycle, we planned a bicycle boat from Kadıköy coast to Maltepe coast. In addition, we plan to build a bicycle boat between the pavement and the road, not only as a coastal road, but also in a side streets. Yes, in the next page. Harun. Yes, we thought that public transportation vehicles should be used more actively, especially on the main roads known as the D100, Turkish means A5, highway, minibus road and Baghdad Street. For this reason, we decided not to allow large vehicles such as trucks and trucks to enter these roads, but to make a separate road for these vehicles from outside the city, reducing urban traffic and minimizing possible accident for those who do not want to travel from outside the city. We planned the east-west direction of the D100 highway to double duct that we want to be. And to be able to use intercity buses or large vehicles from one floor. Yes, by planning these highways, we paid attention to making separate roads for private vehicles for public transportation. We thought of rail systems and another means of transportation. We plan to use a rail system that traps to entire Kadıköy in east-west direction over the ground in the middle of the D100 highway, the other streets and streets from underground. We thought to prefer sea transportation instead of rail system in places where it passes. Also described as Anatolia's gateway of Istanbul, we planned Haydarpaşa station as the center of rail system. We planned sea transportation as another means of transportation. We planned a ferry service from Kadıköy Pier, all the districts of Istanbul that are the on the coast of between Kadıköy, Bostancı. We even aimed to provide transportation to other cities and other countries from here. We considered the use of pedestrian routes as the last means of transportation. We planned areas close to vehicle traffic and aimed to use only pedestrian and bicycle paths. Thank you. Go on, please, Ulaş.
Thank you, Bülent. The responding of our request we started with the transformation of the scaffolding, which is 40.23 because it is a earthquake zone. The location of the buildings will be determined by calculating the tsunami effect that may occur in the coastal arena due to fact that the decrease has a sea size. It will have a positive effect on house pricing by ensuring that each building has a view of the sea. Before starting funding of the buildings, all buildings will be built in accordance with the standards in order not to experience problems in transportation of the
I think we cannot hear anything.
Hello, I'm Gamze. I am talking about geotechnical works. You can see in the screen the structural geology distribution map of Istanbul. The Kadıköy area has three different soil structure type. The yellow area consists of current and tectonic sediments, so this area has low bearing capacity and contains loose ground elements. The brown area consists of old age rock units. This zone is more durable than the other zone. And the blue area consists of also age rock units, but this area has the most durable soil structure type. Next page. Looking at the soil classification map, shows that the area has four different type of ground structure. The green areas has more durable ground structure than the red or yellow area. Next page. So soil distribution map shows that the area which take part in alluvial formation shows very soft and soft soil property. Next page. You can see in the screen the liquefaction risk location base map. The red area consisting of alluvial sediments carry the risk of liquefaction. So we do not make multi-story structure at this area, but we make some soil improvements work, like jet ground, fibro flotation, or dynamic compaction. We use three different foundation type. The rock footing foundation type is used for the structure which requires shallow foundation, and the friction pile method and mini pile method are used for the structure which requires deep foundation. Thank you. Next page.
Again, me. Construction management. As a team, we plan to build our district in three stages. Stages one, infrastructure construction. In our district, first infrastructure works were determined in line with geotechnical efforts. A period of 10 months has been determined for the completion of the project. The project was thoroughly explained to the construction teams, and it was determined how the work would be organized. The project was followed regularly during the construction process. 1,200 workers were employed during the construction project. Next page. Stage 2. Transport and environmental construction. After the infrastructure construction is completed, it has been determined how many types of transportation will be used. Road routes and necessary green areas were determined in line with the geotechnical report. A period of 12 months has been determined for the completion of the project. Work has begun for the construction and greening of the determined green areas. 1,500 workers were employed during the construction of project. Stage 2, structural construction. The number of housing and service buildings required after the
location and environment construction was determined. The location of the structure were determined according to geotechnical reports and population density. A number of residential and service buildings were proposed. A period of 18 months has been determined for the completion of the project. It was regularly checked and followed up during the construction project. 2,500 workers were employed during the construction of the project. Thank you. Go on, Murat.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. I'm Murat Kurnaz. I will talk about quality management, safety concern, and environmental issues. Let's start with quality management. Structural components of a building, its technological features affect its quality. The system chosen for the building, the technology used for its construction, the construction materials, their compatibility with each other, the joints of the building elements and solution shapes are features that affect quality. While planning our city, we planned it accordance with these quality management criteria. Secondly, I will talk about safety concerns. Next page, please. We took safety precautions while starting work. We designed the building in accordance with the regulations. We built earthquake-resistant building. We took measures against natural disasters such as winds and storms. We built safe areas for natural disasters. Finally, I will talk about environmental issues. There are some environmental issues such as traffic, pollution, noise. We took various measures for this. Thanks for watching. You can ask your question.
Okay, let's have the questions. All right, I think I can see here Aziz Yılmaz.
Yeah, teacher, I have no question.
Okay, I can see here Ceren Düğün.
What was the most difficult structure to build? Hocam sesin geldi mi?
Yes, geldi. I can hear you, but I'm not sure about the group members.
Okay.
I think this was a tough question.
I think I can answer that. Because of the soft soil, probably the moisture structures will be hard to build, I guess.
What type of structures you say?
Mostly, I think I'm saying wrong, but mostly, am I saying wrong?
Well, I am not sure what you mean exactly.
I mean, I was talking about tall buildings because of the soft soil and the fault lines.
High rise, you know, tall buildings. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Maybe we can take one more question. Emirhan Egemen. Okay. Emirhan Egemen. Oh, he's not here, actually. I think he has connection problems. Let's take note of this. Murat Keleş.
Professor, I have no question. I wanted to ask, but I couldn't find anyone.
Oh, okay. Everything was clear, you say.
A little bit.
Okay, maybe we ask you a question then. What part of the presentation you like most? Or what part of the design, you know, your friends presented you like most?
In my presentation, I will present you the quality management.
I'm saying the
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. I've come to there. I liked the quality management most part.
Okay. This is the part you are involved in your project as well, I think. Huh?
Yes, that's why.
Okay. It makes sense, I think, that you say I like that part most because I am involved that part and I like to be involved in those parts. That's okay. All right, let's proceed with the next one.
Olaf and Brick joint venture.
Hi, everyone. I'm Botan. Welcome our presentation. I will talk about how part of construction management and give some information about our presentation. The area we choose for our presentation is Üsküdar. While designing the project, we generally decided that we wanted a environmentally friendly and touristic city. On this map, you can see the roads and designed some certain parts of city like the hospital, city hall, university area, and new city center. At the first, it was to complete new city center, develop touristic area, complete restoration, and some residential area. After that, educational institutes and zone will be completed. Project with social areas will be completed. Each of three periods is estimated to last approximately 15 years. Your turn, Ali. Thank you.
Thank you. Next page, please. Hello, everyone. My issue is construction management. You can see cost table in the screen. According to the calculations we made with the help of the data in the Resmi Gazete, the fees spent in making the change in approximately 20 billion Turkish liras. The most important factor to be considered in cost calculation is the area and the number of floors. According to these data and the value of money per square meter, the cost table is planned. Deviations may occur when calculating the cost. This deviation can be higher or lower than the money value we calculate. Next page, please. Employment status is also discussed in addition to the cost table. There are some techniques used in calculating the workforce. These techniques are as follows. First, historical data are calculated. Then the experts are the most important compared with similar works. And the most important and last parts is the duration of all individual items. Thank you.
Hi, dear friends, I am Ahmed. Under this heading, we are going to show you what we did about structural engineering. Firstly, we choose materials to be used in the construction of buildings. While creating buildings and structures suitable for its purpose, we created a planning that will meet the requirements of structural engineering, which is a curtain security, sufficient rigidity, and economic dimensioning. Due to facts that our region is the earthquake zone of Istanbul, we didn't miss using seismic isolators in high-rise building that could collapse in a severe earthquake. Next page, please. The map we can see on this page show us which region our major structures are located and how they are located. To put briefly, we have placed the low-rise buildings like cafe, restaurant, and dedicated house on the coastal area. As we progressed into the inner part of the city, the number of floors also increased. Mass housing was planned far from the city center, but with their own mini centers. We have positioned prison and factory-style buildings away from the city, and we have also placed emergency lines so that they can easily reach every area. We included all the buildings that we have to meet all the needs of the city in our report. The next page, please. Buildings which are among the leading factors causing global warming consume 2/5 of the world's total material and energy and 1/6 of the clean water. Buildings provide half of the carbon emissions, and we spend more than 90% of our time indoors. We have planned our city to minimize these effects. We planned our buildings in terms of air quality, land protection, and water saving in a beneficial and appropriate way to environment. We preferred passive house style building construction in order to minimize the world consuming situation. Thank you. Your turn, Yasin. Next page, please.
Hi, everyone. I'm Yasin Fatih. Today, I will tell you about green buildings and the design of buildings. We prefer natural climate plants. We collect rainwater in the underground tanks. We use this water in tiled flushing to grow organic vegetables on green roofs. We use more economical insulations. The water used for things like showers is recycled for gardening. Next page, please. Now I will talk about building design of buildings. We use double wall insulation, including concrete and stone walls. We provide solar control by placing the buildings in the right directions. Next page, please. The curving walls mention in the infinity of nature with their natural shapes while keeping the building connected to the outside. The windows are made of double glazing to prevent heat loss, and white roof reflects sunrise back and has a cooling effect. Since all houses have easy access to public transport, the use of private vehicles will be reduced. Therefore, carbon gas emission will be reduced. Next page, please.
Hello, I will talk about transportation engineering. According to the calculations of the Chamber of Electrical Engineers, the energy required for the minimum living standards of a family of four was 230 kilowatt. These panels, which are planned to be along 21 kilometers, estimate that there will be a power generation of 36,750 kilowatt per day. When we look at it monthly, we calculate it as an average of 1,103 megawatts. Next page. Many ways will be built due to increased people cycling, but it may not possible to cycle in hilly area like Üsküdar. Bike escalators were considered as a solution to this problem. They were planned to be installed in touristic and hilly neighborhoods such as Kuzguncuk, Selimiye, İcadiye. The escalators will transport cyclists up the slopes for a low fee. The rider puts his foot on the machine's pedal at the push of the button and climbs the slope without leaving their bike. Next page.
Sorry, I'm turned on microphone. I will continue transportation part. Electric bus. While they use the electric vehicles continue to increase worldwide. It's
you cannot see the presentation, I think.
Sorry.
Just share your screen.
Can you see?
Okay, now we can see. Yes.
While the use of the electric vehicles continue to increase worldwide, its efficiency and environmental friendliness also make the vehicles attractive for public transportation. We designed the four bus lines in densely populated areas in order to provide transportation to citizens. We designed a new tram line to the city, use Haydarpaşa Station. The tram line continue from Haydarpaşa to Kuzguncuk, which has increased the tourist attraction of the city. Marina Port. We choose the strategic location by choosing the port next to the industrial zone. Apart with a effective port management, we have provided the necessary transport and ensure that there is the high level of opportunity efficiency. We designed the one side of the port area, which we will use of the commercial and touristic purposes. As the marina, which cafes and restaurants like Monaco Marine, while one side we work commercially, we have designed to carry out the wide range of tourism attractives in the marina area of tourism purposes, while providing the wide range of the port services in the commercial department. Thank you.
Hydraulic engineering. Seawater treatment costs have declined considerably in today's technology. We reduced the cost of seawater treatment to mains water costs. In reverse osmosis technology, water treatment is provided by pumping solution under high pressure and retaining salt and other impurities. In this water treatment plant, we store the water needs of the city for about 2 months with a tank with 100,000 cubic meter water to store the treated water. The water coming out of the warehouse is transmitted all over the city, every neighborhood. Next page.
When water comes out of our house, it's contaminated with chemicals, including phosphate used in waste and cleaning products. Wastewater is first collected in sewage system and then processed in a related facility to remove components harmful to the environment and human health. In this treatment plant, it's aimed to make both physical and chemical treatment, biological treatment, advanced purification, natural purification system available to people. Wastewater from every neighborhood of the city is cleaned at this facility and prevent from damaging the environment.
Hello again, engineering mechanics. The materials used in the construction of the structures were tested for durability. The earthquake performance of reinforced concrete columns were examined in order to ensure that the structures were earthquake resistant. Seismic isolators were used in all of the buildings built. The reason for this is that Istanbul province is right next to the North Anatolian fault line. Intelligent building systems were used in most of the housing estates. Various systems working with multi-story car park systems and Renewable energy systems can be given as examples of these systems. Thank you. Next page.
Extra structural security measures were taken in public offices and private buildings in the city center. In the construction of these buildings, clay material, which has advantages such as lightening the building load, increasing building flexibility and natural thermal isolation, was used instead of aggregating concrete mortar. Next page, please. Next issue is geology. Since Üsküdar is close to the beach and the fault line, we gave importance to geotechnical studies in our project. First, ground dynamics was investigated. Subsequently, the soil mechanics were investigated and reported. At the end of these studies, as a geological structure, it has been determined that Üsküdar sits on the rocks known as Istanbul Paleozoic Sequence. The soft soils are extremely low and landslide of ground liquefaction will not occur in case of an earthquake. As the last process, the foundation construction of the
All the buildings that have been all the buildings that have been built constructing the geotechnic factors. The strange and durability of the harbor built as an economic resource on the shore has been examined and approved by the geotechnical unit. In addition, geotechnical investigations were carried out with the utmost care while constructing any building. Thanks for listening to our presentation.
Thank you. Let's have the questions.
Can I ask a question, Professor?
Go ahead, please.
How did you determine the city center?
Okay, the center is too close to everywhere. For this reason, it's very easy to reach the center from all places.
Thank you.
Can I ask a question?
Go ahead, please.
Why didn't you build a subway?
I can answer it. I don't think the metro line is needed in the city. Because there is no enough space and budget for the metro line is a big budget, need a big budget. I think there are enough transportation line, I think. Thank you.
Thank you, Hans.
If there is no more question, we can proceed with the next one.
This is the last one. DMM and BNKM joint venture.
Okay, let's proceed with the presentation.
Hello, Professor. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
So before we start, I will need to inform you that one of our friends is not showing up. So I will have to do his presentation part. So today we'll give you a quick presentation about the city of our dream. In this presentation, we will talk about the city of our dream, how we imagine it and how we would like it to be and how we are going to build it. We are going to cover the following topics: the location and purpose, the financial planning, the design and construction planning, the construction management, quality management, safety concerns and environmental issues. The location of the city. Our city will be located in Kocaeli province area in Marmara region. its name will be Deringe. It has an area of approximately 196 kilometers square. Deringe is the place with the deepest coast in the region. Since it's suitable for establishing a boat, we made the biggest investment here and built a modern and solid boat. Since we can use the sea transportation well, we have built many factories in the boat. We have become an important transportation point for both our own trade and trade in the neighboring provinces. And we improved the city's economy significantly. The purpose of the city. Just as a typical city provides the infrastructure, streets, building, power, water, government necessary for people to live and work, the purpose of the city will provide the foundation for citizens to choose a more meaningful lifestyle. Developing and sustaining this environment will be our main goal. My friend will continue from here and talk about the financial planning.
Can you hear my voice?
Yes, we can.
Right, guys. Today I'm going to talk about financial planning. I'm Barış. Five-story building cost, construction made from reinforced concrete, cost approximately 1 million Turkish liras for rock construction building, 500 metrekare area. School cost, construction made from reinforced concrete, cost approximately 15 million Turkish liras for rock construction built in 2000 square meter area. Mall cost, construction made from steel construction, cost approximately 15 million Turkish liras built in 15,000 square meter area. And skyscraper, construction made from steel construction approximately 250 million Turkish liras built in 1,000 square meter area. Hospital cost, construction made from reinforced concrete, cost approximately 100 million Turkish liras for rock construction built in of 15,000 square meter area. Mosque cost, construction made from reinforced concrete, cost approximately 10 million Turkish liras for road construction built in 1,200 square meter area. Then my friend will continue with design. Thank you.
Yeah, hello everyone, my name is Kaan Kırtay and today I will talk about the design and construction planning part of our dream city. And I will start with city planning. While we were designing our city, we inspired of Barcelona because the city planning is extremely organized and unique. It makes easier transportation and settlement very effectively by united blocks and wide main roads. Moreover, it looks magnificent and elegant from top of view. We planned that there will be double lane main roads and single lane streets in our city. There won't be any permission to construct skyscraper and high-rise towers in a seaside, not to affect other citizens' view. Furthermore, it's planned that it will be more green areas in both seashore and city center. And in structure parts, we prefer that it will be different types of structures as shown. It's known that İzmit Derince is in the fault line, so most of the structures will be low floor buildings. The reason is we plan to make search and rescue operations in emergency situations much easier. We decided to use steel construction in public buildings and towers. In addition, all these buildings have a common feature that makes smart and multifunctional design. Also, nearly every building will have an underground car park to get more space and reduce traffic jam. In foundation parts, it's shown that the soil type of the Derince, and it's understood that the surface of the ground is not suitable for buildings, so deep foundation technique must be used in the structures. In addition, concrete walls had to be used to strengthen the foundation. And transportation, we know that transportation is a very important issue for cities. We plan to construct subway lines, continuous flow intersection, bicycleways, tram lines, and airports. Especially a subway line had to be built between airport and city center. Also, continuous flow intersection and tram lines must be done to reduce traffic jam. Moreover, we decided to make 50% less cost for public transportation at work hours, and entrance to the city center at certain times must be paid for the private vehicles, at the aim of support citizens to use public transportation. And lastly, infrastructure works. We designed a clean water refining facilities and rainwater storage system all over the city. It's known that global warming is rising day by day, thus lack of water problem can be occurred in cities. We plan that build rainwater storage in some specific areas of city. Also, it's planned that construct the clean water refining facility in a seashore and pipeline to supply this clean water to every part of the city. Thank you.
And now we will talk about the construction management and the construction phases of the city. The first phase will be the initiation phase, where we already talked about the main purpose of the construction project. The second phase is the planning phase, where we will identify the scope of the work and identify the resources. The third phase will be the implementation and execution phase, where we will ensure that the budget in the planning stage is followed. The fourth stage will be performance and monitoring stage, where we will keep tracking of the development of the city, and the final stage will be the closing stage, where we will deliver the final products like the buildings and facilities, etc., to the citizens and clients. In the planning phase, we calculated the area of our city, and it turned out it will be 222.97 kilometers squared. We also did some calculations for our city to figure out how many structures of each type we will need. For example, the main building will be a five-story building, and each building will be five-story and has two apartments, and each apartment will be able to host from 5 to 7 people, so each building will host from 50 to 70 citizens. So to host 100,000 people, we will need at least 1,400 to 2,000 buildings, which will cost us 1.4 to 2.0 billion. We also decided that we will make 5 skyscrapers to provide offices and workplace for people, which will cost 1.25 billion. We also will build 3 hospitals that will cost 3 million, and 15 schools that will cost 225 million. Three malls that will cost 150 million, and 5 mosques that will cost 50 million. And the total will be 3.975 plus or minus 0.6 billion. In the third stage, in the implementation and execution stage, it will approximately take at least 1 year for a 5-story building to be completed, and more than 2 years for a building that's above 4 stories. So we expect that the city will be completed if all buildings started at the same time to be finished in maximum 3 years. In the performance and monitoring stage, we will start firstly with the infrastructure works, like water, roads, and electricity. Secondly, we will begin the housing stage. And thirdly, we will provide necessary services like hospitals, schools, and markets. In the final stage, we will provide entertainment services like malls, parks, and playgrounds. And in the closing stage, we will deliver the final products, the buildings and facilities, etc., to the citizens and clients. Thank you.
Okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes, we can see now.
Okay, my part is quality management and safety concerns, so I'm going to talk about it now. Okay, quality management. In this topic, we will look at our town's efficiency, which type of efficiency, trade efficiency and production efficiency, you know, governing efficiency, sort of stuff like that. Okay, designing our town most cost-effective way, so we will use our resources geniusly, because it's a small town and we have a budget, so we have to stick to it. In the case of developing Derince, we started with looking the soil, environment, etc. So then we decided to use the right materials for our constructions to prevent the bad things can happen in the future. When we looking the undeveloped town of Derince, we found a harbor so we can do fishing, naval transporting, sort of stuff like that. We also, the town is between two big cities, Istanbul and Ankara. So this will be a pretty good spot to develop a town. Of course, we have a budget and we have to stick to it and use it generously and carefully and make use full of it. Okay, safety concerns. As we're developing our town, which is in Kocaeli Derince, it's in an earthquake zone, so we have to take precautions. And the biggest thing we did is seismic isolators in every building, so we will guarantee that this town will survive, even survive after a big earthquake. Also, we strengthened our buildings with steel. Okay, as you see here, this is the earthquake zone in Turkey, and our town is in Kocaeli, so we are in earthquake zone, so we have to be careful. Okay, secondly, we set up fire extinguishers in each building, so we can help extinguishing the fire in the first hand. Okay, thirdly, for the floods, we improved our infrastructure so we can recover our lost water and prevent a big water impact. We decided that it is important to safeguard this town because this will be an important town for transportation between Istanbul and Ankara. This is my part, and I'm handing over to my friend Furkan. Furkan Göpet, please.
Hello. Can you see my screen?
Yes, I think we can see your screen, but not your presentation.
Okay. Hello. I will talk about environmental issues. I am starting with recycling. We put enough garbage containers. We separated our garbage containers as paper, glass, and organic for recycling. We prevented water pollution by preventing factor wastes from being dumped into rivers. We also solved air pollution by placing filters in the chimneys of our factories. We attached great importance to afforestation, both to prevent erosion, to live in the nature, and to protect ecological balance. We carried out afforestation work wherever possible. We prevented and flood by planning our infrastructure works according to highest rainfall times of the last 50 years. Thank you for kind attention. If you have a question, we can answer.
All right, thank you for the presentation. Let's have the questions. Who has the question? Someone said I have
me.
A question. Okay, Mohammed.
Have you used seismic isolators? If you used, where did you use it?
As I said, we used in every building. You know, this was my part in quality management. We used in every building. Why? Because this is an important town to make the connections between Istanbul and Ankara in our imagination. So, yeah, that's it.
All right, with that, I think we finish our presentations. Am I right, Oğuz?
Yeah, Professor.
Well, we finished the presentations today. I am sure you were all excited to make your presentations, but also to see what the town of your friends dream. And there were different ideas, different considerations, and you listened to all of them. Now, 4 years from now, actually, you will be at a different position. You will be graduating. And at that time, you actually acquire lots of information related to civil engineering and civil design. And then maybe you'll come back to these presentations and compare what you think at that time
and what you presented this time. Actually, it will be really interesting for you to see your development. Okay. Thank you for you all for the wonderful work you did.